about almost 7 years since I started with the Gen Next collection. I come from a family of doctors, so for them, you know, fashion was nowhere on the horizon. So it's something which I sort of was interested in, but it took me a while to sort of figure out whether I wanted to do this as a serious career or whether it's just a passing fancy. The moment I plunged and I got through NID, NIFT both, I chose NID. I had a scholarship to go study in Paris at École des Arts Décoratifs. I interned with Celine, which is a part of the Louis Vuitton group. I came back, I worked with, you know, did my final project with Abu Jani, Sandeep Khosla, worked with Neeru Kumar. I taught at NID for 6 months and then I launched my line. The autumn winter line which I'm showing at Will's right now is called Maia, which is the Maori word for brave. Now Maori are the original settlers of New Zealand. The Maori women of the yesteryears were sort of, they were an interesting contrast. They were a mix of femininity, at the same time they were tough warriors. And the tattoos of that they had on their faces were called the Moko tattoos. And now we didn't want to take it as is, so we abstracted it. Keeping those things in mind, we sort of worked with perforated leather for this season. We've done embroideries on organza to simulate those. We've done the same patterns both in Zardozi couching embroidery in a modern fabric, as well as a shibori, which is like the Japanese art of stitch resist. I've done these outfits, you know, where the tattoo is supposed to sort of, the fabric is body colored, so the embroidery looks like a tattoo on the skin. I think for me as a designer, it's important to take any inspiration that you have and abstract and add your own layer to it.
Subscribe to Trendspotters.tv for more such updates.